In these examples, we want to determine what trigonometric function we would use based upon the given information in the right triangle. So this question reviews the definition of the trig functions as ratios of the lengths of sides of right triangles. And to do this, we should identify the opposite side, adjacent side, and hypotenuse in relation to angle A. So if this is angle A, this would be the side opposite angle A. The hypotenuse is always opposite the right angle. So here's our right angle, so side C would be the hypotenuse. And then side B is one of the sides that forms angle A but is not the hypotenuse, so this would be the adjacent side. So if we want to use a trig function that involves angle A, the length of side B, and the length of side C, we would have to use the cosine function because cosine of an angle is equal to the ratio of the length of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse. So in this example, we'd have the cosine of angle A is equal to the ratio of B to C. Now if you need to review the definition of the six trig functions as the ratio of lengths of sides of a right triangle, you may want to pause the video here and review. Let's go and take a look at two more examples. Here's another example of the same type. We want to determine what trig function we would use based upon the given information. So if we're referring to angle B, side B would be the opposite side of angle B. This side here would be the hypotenuse because it's opposite the right angle, and it's also the longest side of the triangle. So side A would be the adjacent side. So using angle B, we want a trig function that involves the length of the opposite side and the length of the adjacent side. And that would be the tangent function. So the tangent of angle B is equal to the ratio of B to A. Here's our last example. Let's go ahead and label the opposite side. Well, if we're referring to angle B, then side B here would be the opposite side. The side opposite the right angle would be the hypotenuse. And this side here would be the adjacent side. So now we want a trig function that involves the opposite side and the hypotenuse, and that would be the sine function. So here we'd have the sine of angle B is equal to the ratio of B to C. I hope these examples were helpful.